Hello everyone, welcome to Tungal online classes. Let us discuss synopsis of 2D geometry, right? Continue. Next point, already we discussed some synopsis in the yesterday class, right? Next point, three or more points are said to be collinear. Already you know collinearity condition, right? Three points are said to be collinear if they lie on the same line. Three or more than three points are said to be collinear if they lie on same straight line, right? If they lie on the same line, then we conclude given points are collinear. Then suppose the points A, B, C are collinear, then what is condition? If three points are collinear, by using distance formula, sum of any two distance is equal to third distance. By using distance formula, sum of two distances is equal to third distance, then we conclude given points are collinear. And similarly, by using slope concept also, we conclude whether given points are collinear or not, right? For collinearity, by using distance formula also we conclude given points are collinear or not. By using slope concept also we conclude whether given points are collinear or not. By using area of the triangle also we conclude whether given points are collinear or not. Sum of any two distances. If I take three points A, B, C, in this order, sum of any two distances. In this manner, AB plus BC, that's equal to AC. In this figure, condition is AB plus BC equal to AC. Sum of two distances equal to third distance. If you take in this order, then AB plus BC equal to AC. AB plus BC equal to AC. Or, if you take its position, instead of ABC, you can take ACB also. Just remember, sum of any two distances ACCB equal to AB means, if you take point like this, suppose point A is here, point C is here and point B is here, then AC plus CB is equal to AB, second condition. Remember, sum of any two distances is equal to third distance, then clearly three points are collinear. BA plus AC equal to BC. Just remember, sum of two distances equal to third distance, then points are collinear by using distance formula. Next, by using slope concept also, we conclude given points are collinear or not. Slope concept by using collinear. One more condition, slope of AB is equal to slope of BC, then ABC are collinear. If three points are collinear, then area of the triangle ABC equal to 0. In this case, just look at this figure. Clearly, point A, B, C are on the same line. If three points are on the same line, then clearly area of the triangle ABC equal to 0. Area of the triangle ABC, initially it was ABC. Suppose it is A, B and C. If these three points are on the same line, means this height becomes 0. Means this point vertex B is also lies on AC, means height becomes 0. If height is 0, means area is 0. If area of the triangle ABC is 0, then what you conclude? Clearly points are collinear. For collinearity, we have three conditions. Three points are said to be collinear if their slopes are equal, or sum of any two distances equal to third distance, or area of the triangle is 0. Next, if P of x comma y is any point on the line passing through A of x1 y1 and B of x2 y2, then the ratio in which P divides AB, already we discussed this point, right? M by N equal to formula. In what ratio point P divides AB? In what ratio point P divides AB? Already we discussed this point, right? Formula x minus x1 divided by x2 minus x. Both are one and the same only. Or m by n is equal to, we can use y coordinate also. That is y minus y1 divided by y2 minus y. If m by n value is positive, then what you conclude? Suppose m by n is positive, then point P divides internally. If ratio is positive, then point divides internally. Suppose ratio is negative, then point divides externally. That's all. Next. This point is not necessary. Already we discussed it. Just remember, sum of two distances equal to third distance, or their slopes are equal. That's all. Next, the ratio in which the line segment joining x1 comma y1 and x2 comma y2 is divided by. In what ratio x-axis divides line joining given two points, right? Just I will explain. The ratio in which the line segment joining, just consider point A of x1 comma y1 and point B of x2 comma y2. In what ratio x-axis divides line segment joining AB? In what ratio x-axis divides line joining AB? Suppose this is x-axis. X-axis divides in the ratio of y1 is to y2. Sorry, it is not. Minus y1 is to y2. X-axis divides line joining given two points in the ratio of minus y1 is to y2. X-axis divides minus y1 is to y2. And y-axis divides. Suppose it is AB line. In what ratio y-axis divides AB line? It is in the ratio of minus x1 is to x2. The ratio in which line segment joining x1 comma x2 and x2, x1 comma y1 and x2 comma y2 is divided by x-axis in the ratio of minus y1 is to y2, y-axis in the ratio of minus x1 is to x2. Remember this point. Next, area of the triangle. Already you know how to find area of the triangle, right? What is the formula? Area of the triangle. Already we know two formulas for finding area of the triangle. Area of the triangle is equal to 1 divided by 2 times height into base. Whenever height and its base is given, then area of the triangle is 1 by 2 times height into base. And one more formula already you know, that is when vertices are given. When vertices are given, then area of the triangle A is equal to, A is equal to 1 by 2 times modulus of x into y minus y. Order is 1, 2, 3. To remember this formula, what we do? Just write x in bracket y minus y. After that, give cyclic order of 1, 2, 3. First take 1, 2, 3. Plus x into, second term x into, just write y minus y. After that, take cyclic order of 1, 2, 3. In for first term take 1, 2, 3. For second term take 2, 3, 1. 2, 3, 1. For third term, again write x into y minus y. Right? Take order 1, 2, 3. Then 2, 3, 1. Then 3, 1, 2. This is area of the triangle whenever vertices are given. And we have shortcut formula for finding area of the triangle. area of the triangle is equal to, for finding area of the triangle whose vertices are x1, y1, x2, y2, and x3, y3. Shortcut formula for finding area of the triangle. Instead of this expression, it takes somewhat time to evaluate area of the triangle. For that reason, we have one shortcut formula for finding area of the triangle. 1 by 2 times it is determinant. Determinant of, it is not modulus sign. Inside, suppose single element is there, then it is modulus. It is modulus of x. This is determinant, suppose x, y, 2, 3. It is determinant of 2 by 2. And determinant concept you will learn in second PUC, right? Just remember how to evaluate determinant of 2 by 2. This is one determinant. Its value is product of diagonal elements minus non-diagonal elements. What is its determinant value? 3x minus 2y. Then I will write one more. 1, 2, 4, 3. What is its determinant value? Determinant of 2 by 2 is nothing but product of diagonal elements. Diagonal. Left top corner to right bottom elements are called diagonal elements. Minus these two are non-diagonal. Its value is product of these two. 3 minus 12. 3 minus 8. 1 into 3 is 3. Minus 4 into 2 is 8. That's equal to minus 5. And determinant value, it may be positive or negative. But while evaluating area, consider positive value. And I will explain how to evaluate 2 by 2 determinant. 2 minus 1, 3 is 0. What is its determinant value? Don't think about its definition. What is meaning of determinant and all those things. Just remember how to evaluate determinant of 2 by 2, right? Determinant of 2 by 2, product of these two elements, 0, minus product of these two elements, minus 3, that's equal to plus 3. Its determinant value is 3. One more example, evaluate x, 2, 0, 3. What is its determinant value? Determinant of 2 by 2 is nothing but product of diagonal elements minus non-diagonal elements. Right? Then it will be 3x minus 0, that's equal to 3x. Its determinant value is 3x. Then determinant of 4, 9, 2 minus 5. Right? What is its determinant value? Product of diagonal elements minus non-diagonal elements. It will be minus 20 minus 18, that's equal to minus 38, right? Determinant of 2 by 2 is nothing but product of diagonal elements minus non-diagonal. Now just you remember how to evaluate 2 by 2 determinant, that's all. Don't think about its definition, what is meaning of determinant and what are the properties, all those things, not necessary. Just remember how to evaluate its determinant value, right? Determinant. Shortcut formula for finding area of the triangle is 1 by 2 times x1 minus x2, y1 minus y2, then x1 minus x3, y1 minus y3. 1 by 2 times area of the triangle is equal to x1 minus x2, area of the triangle is equal to 1 by 2 times determinant. First element is x1 minus x2, next element y1 minus y2, in second row x1 minus x3, y1 minus y3. This is area of the triangle. This is formula for finding area of the triangle. It is shortcut formula. Shortcut formula for finding area of the triangle. This formula not necessary. For this also just use this concept, right? This formula is not necessary. Take this as x1, y1, x2y2 x3y3 after simplification you get this expression only 1 by 2 times x1 into y2 minus x2 into y1 square units. This formula not necessary. By using this concept only we can evaluate, right? Area of the triangle by using shortcut formula. 1 by 2 times x1 minus x2. x1 minus x2, y1 minus y2, x1 minus x3, y1 minus y3. This is area of the triangle by using shortcut formula. 1 by 2 times determinant. How to read this one? Determinant 2, 4, 9, 6. This is determinant of 2 by 2 determinant. Determinant of 2 cross 2 means 2 rows and 2 columns. 2 by 2 means 2 rows and 2 columns. How to read this one? Determinant of 2, 4. First pronounce row elements. After that column. 2, 4, 9, 6. Here area of the triangle is 1 by 2 times determinant of x1 minus x2, y1 minus y2, x1 minus x3, y1 minus y3. Next, if G is centroid, if G is centroid of the triangle ABC, then area of the triangle ABC is. I will explain what is centroid, right? Already you know definition of median, right? Median of the triangle. Just take triangle ABC, ABC. AD is median. When AD is median? AD is median of the triangle when D is midpoint of BC. And similarly, BE is median when E is midpoint. After that, CF is also median when F is midpoint. Clearly, AD, BE and CF are medians. Then point of concurrence means point of intersection of medians. Point of concurrence of medians is called centroid. It is denoted with Z. The point of intersection of medians or point of concurrence of medians of the triangle is known as centroid. Point of intersection of medians is known as centroid. G is centroid of the triangle, point of concurrence of medians. And one more thing, median of the triangle, centroid divides median of the triangle in the ratio of 2:1. Suppose this is G, it is D, it is always in the ratio of 2:1. Remember one point, centroid divides each median in the ratio of 2:1. Centroid of the triangle divides each median in the ratio of 2:1. Then, in what ratio? G divides CF starts from vertex 2:1. If you take median B, then this is 2:1. First one, each median divides, centroid divides each median in the ratio of 2:1. This is one point. Suppose it is triangle ABC, right? Centroid. Centroid divides each median in the ratio of 2:1, right? G is centroid of the triangle. Then centroid of the triangle formula G, and clearly it is D, whose vertices x1 y1 x2 y2 x3 y3, right? then g is equal to, or g coordinates I will take it as x comma y. G is equal to x1 plus x2 plus x3 divided by 3. X1 plus x2 plus x3 divided by 3 comma y1 plus y2 plus y3 divided by 3. This is centroid of the triangle whose vertices are x1 comma y1, x2 comma y2 and x3 comma y3. This is formula for a centroid of the triangle. Already you know what is meaning of centroid. Centroid means point of intersection of medians. And a centroid divides each median in the ratio of 2:1. And take 2, 1. Vertex side take 2. Other side 1. It is always 2:1. Take in the direction from A to D, not in the direction of D to A. 2:1. If you use section formula, then clearly you get this formula. By using section formula we get centroid, right? This is centroid of the triangle formula. This is centroid of the triangle. Now G is centroid of the triangle, then area of the triangle in terms of centroid. This is G, right? It is A, B, C. Then we can write area of the triangle in terms of these three triangles. Here we have three triangles, A, B, G and B, G, C and A, C, G. We have three triangles, right? If G is centroid of the triangle, then area of the triangle is equal to 3 times area of the triangle A, B, G. Because this triangle is divided into three triangles, right? One triangle, second triangle and third triangle. This area of the triangle in terms of these three triangles is, area of the triangle ABC is equal to 3 times area of the triangle ABZ, ABZ or 3 times BGC or 3 times AGC. Area of the triangle ABC in terms of these three triangles. Area of the triangle ABC is equal to 3 times area of the triangle ABZ or 3 times area of the triangle BCZ or 3 times area of the triangle ACZ. Instead of finding directly area of the triangle, we can use these three triangles. Area of the triangle ABC equal to 3 times area of the triangle ABZ or 3 times area of the triangle BGC or 3 times area of the triangle AGC. These are three possibilities. If G is centroid of the triangle, then area of the triangle is these three formulas. You can use any one. That is depends on which vertices are given. Suppose centroid of the triangle and B and C vertices are given. Two vertices and centroid is given, then also we can find area of the triangle ABC. That is depends on which vertices are given. Suppose vertex B, vertex C and centroid is given, then area of the triangle ABC equal to 3 times area of the triangle BGC. Suppose vertex A, vertex B and centroid is given, then 3 times area of the triangle AGB or ABZ. Suppose vertex A and C are given and centroid is given, then area of the triangle ABC is 3 times AGC, right? Three possibilities. Instead of giving all three vertices, two vertex and its centroid is given, then this formula is applicable. Two vertices and one centroid. Centroid and two vertices are given, then area of the triangle ABC formula. Whenever three vertices are given, already we have formula, right? Next point, if D, E, F are midpoints of side AB, BC, CA of triangle ABC, then area of the triangle area of the triangle ABC is equal to, I will explain how it is 4 times. Just consider triangle ABC, right? Triangle A, B and C, and clearly midpoints of sides they have given. Midpoints D, E, F are the midpoints of AB, BC, CA. What is midpoint of AB? Midpoint of AB is D. And what is midpoint of BC? BC midpoint is E. And what is midpoint of CA? CA midpoint is F. If you join all these midpoints, then you get 4 triangles, right? Clearly, if D, E, F are midpoints of sides AB, BC, CA of triangle ABC, then area of the triangle ABC is, area of this triangle ABC equal to 4 times any one of the triangle. Area of the whole triangle, area of the triangle ABC is equal to 4 times any one of the triangle. This is one triangle, second triangle, third triangle and fourth triangle. Whenever midpoints of sides of triangle ABC is given, then area of the triangle ABC equal to 4 times area of triangle ADF. ADF. Or else DBE or FEC or DEF. 4 possibilities. Whenever midpoints of sides of triangle ABC are given, then area of that triangle in terms of their midpoints. D, E, F are the midpoints of side AB, BC and CA. Then area of the triangle ABC equal to 4 times area of triangle 1. Area of triangle 1 or area of triangle 2. What is second triangle? DBE. Then FEC, DEF or ADF. If DE and F are midpoints of sides AB, BC, CA of triangle ABC, then area of the triangle is, area of this triangle ABC in terms of these smaller triangles, right? 4 times this triangle is divided into 4 equal parts, 4 triangles. This area is same as this area, is same as this area. All these areas are equal. This is suppose 2 square units, then this is 2, this is 2, this is 2. These 4 areas are one and the same. Area of the triangle ABC equal to 4 times any one of the triangle, right? Next. Area of the triangle formed by A comma 1 divided by A. Vertices are A comma 1 by A. X coordinate and its Y coordinate is reciprocal of X coordinate. And B of B comma 1 divided by B. And vertex C is C comma 1 divided by C. Then area of this triangle is, means suppose area of the triangle, it is one of the shortcut formula. Or else you can use the usual formula, determinant of x1 minus determinant of 1 by 2 times determinant of x1 minus x2, second element y1 minus y2, third element x1 minus x3, y1 minus y3. Or else remember this formula, whenever whose vertices are a comma 1 by a, b comma 1 by b, C comma 1 by C, means A comma 1 by A, vertex B, B comma 1 by B and vertex C, C comma 1 by C, then area of this triangle is directly modulus of A minus B into B minus C into C minus A divided by 2ABC. It is one of the shortcut formula. Whenever these vertices are given, y coordinate is reciprocal of x coordinate, then use this formula, or else you can use that formula, that is 1 by 2 times determinant x1 minus x2, y1 minus y2, next element x1 minus x3, y1 minus y3. You can use this formula also. For these vertices, if you use this formula, then also you get same answer. For easier simplification, just remember this formula. Whenever whose vertices are in the form of a comma 1 by a, b comma 1 by b, and c comma 1 by c, then area of the triangle is a minus b, b minus c, and c minus a divided by 2abc, modulus sign. Why? Because area is positive, right? Or else you can use this formula only for area of the triangle. It is one of the shortcut formula for finding area of the triangle, right? Next, area of quadrilateral. Area of quadrilateral, whenever whose vertices are given, right? Whenever whose vertices, quadrilateral means it may be a parallelogram, or it may be a rectangle, or it may be a square, or it may be a rhombus, any one of the quadrilateral. Whenever whose vertices are x1 comma y1, x2 comma y2, x3 comma y3, and x4 comma y4. Suppose one of the quadrilateral with four vertices, x1 comma y1, b of x2 comma y2, c of x3 comma y3, or else you can take in the serial order, c of x3 comma y3 and d of x4 comma y4. Then what is area of this quadrilateral? 1 by 2 times 1, 3, it is also determinant. Required area ABCD is equal to 1 by 2 times determinant x1 minus x3, y1 minus y3, then x2 minus x4, y2 minus, y2 minus y4. This is area of quadrilateral. It is one of the shortcut formula. Area of quadrilateral whose vertices are x1 comma y1, x2 comma y2, x3 comma y3, and x4 comma y4 is 1 by 2 times determinant x1 minus x3, y1 minus y3, x2 minus x4, y2 minus y4. Proof of this formula is not necessary. Just remember this formula. Area of quadrilateral, shortcut formula for finding area of the quadrilateral. Whenever whose vertices are given. Then already you know area of equilateral triangle. Area of equilateral triangle is root 3 divided by 4 times side length whole square. In this case, A is length of side length, then root 3 divided by 4 times a square, where a is length of the side of the triangle. Area of the equilateral triangle, root 3 by 4 times side length whole square, right? And this formula is not necessary. Already you know how to find angle between two lines, right? Angle between two lines. Remembering this formula is not necessary, because already you know angle between two lines formula. How to find angle between two lines? Just finding their slopes, then use tan theta is equal to modulus of m2 minus m1 divided by 1 plus m1 into m2. That's all. Or else you can remember this formula. If O is the origin, means here three points they have given, right? O is the origin, P of x1 comma y1 and Q of x2 comma y2 are two points, then cos of that angle, angle made by these two lines at the origin, by using angle between two lines formula, if you find tan theta, after that you can write cos theta. this formula I think it is not necessary, right? Or else if O is origin, P of x1 comma y1 and Q of x2 comma y2 are two points, then cos of angle POQ means, just I will draw the figure, right? This is origin, this is origin and two points P, this is origin and one more point Q. Then cos of angle, suppose this angle is theta, cos of angle theta, cos of POQ is equal to x1 into x2 plus y1 into y2 divided by square root of x1 square plus y1 square into square root of x2 square plus y2 square, that's all. Cos of this angle, angle POQ, cos of angle POQ is equal to x1 into x2. What is x1? X1 is x coordinate of first point and x2 is x coordinate of second point. So cos of POQ is equal to x1 into x2 plus y1 into y2 divided by square root of x1 square plus y1 square into square root of x2 square plus y2 square. Then types of triangles, acute angle triangle, obtuse angle triangle and right angle triangle, right? Acute angle triangle, if all three angles are angles in a triangle, this is not small d, triangle are acute, then that triangle is known as acute triangle triangle. If all three angles in a triangle are acute, means less than 90 degree, then that triangle is called an acute angle triangle. Then what is condition of acute angle triangle? Suppose vertices are given. Suppose vertices A of x1, y1, B of x2, y2 and C of x3, y3. Then if triangle ABC is an acute angle triangle, then one of the condition is holds good. Is an acute angle triangle, then these three conditions are holds good. Sum of squares, sorry, here something went wrong. AB square plus BC square is greater than AC square. Means sum of squares of any two sides is greater than square of third side. This is entirely wrong, right? I will write here condition. If this triangle is acute angle triangle, then conditions are AB square plus BC square is greater than AC square. When this triangle is acute angle triangle, and one more condition, BC square plus CA square, sum of squares of any two sides is greater than square of third side, that is greater than AB square. Next, third condition, CA square plus AB square is greater than BC square. When given triangle is acute angle triangle, then these three conditions are holds good. Sum of, just remember, sum of squares of any two sides, sum of squares of any two sides is greater than square of third side, then we conclude given points or given triangle is acute angle triangle. This is condition for acute angle triangle, right? AB square plus BC square is sum of squares of any two sides, sum of squares of two sides is greater than square of third side, then clearly triangle is acute angle triangle. Here something went wrong. Instead of AB2, it is AB square plus BC square is greater than AC square. BC square plus CA square is greater than AB square. AB square plus AC square is greater than BC square. In your material, it is correct only. In material also, it is given, right? If these three conditions are holds good, then we conclude given triangle is acute angle triangle. Sum of squares of any two sides is greater than square of third side, then clearly triangle is acute angle triangle. Next, obtuse angle triangle. If any one of the three angles is greater than right angle, if one of the angle is more than 90 degree, then it is obtuse angle triangle. one of the angle. If all three angles are less than 90, it is acute angle triangle. If one of the angle is more than 90, then it is obtuse angle triangle. Then what is condition to conclude given triangle is acute angle or obtuse angle or right angle? For acute angle, sum of squares of any two sides is greater than square of third side. If one of the condition is holds good, if any one of the condition, it is first condition, it is holds good, then we conclude given triangle is obtuse angle, or this condition, or this one, it is AB square. AB square plus BC square is greater than AC square. Then BC square plus CA square is greater than AB square. And third one is less. AB square plus AC square is less than BC square, right? Sum of squares of two sides greater than square of third side. Two conditions greater than, third condition less than. Here just interchange. Two conditions greater, one condition less. These two just interchanged. This sign becomes in the second position. Remaining all are one and the same. Lesser sign. If one of these three condition is holds good, then clearly given triangle is obtuse angle triangle, right? AB square plus BC square is greater than AC square, and BC square plus CA square is greater than AB square, and AB square plus AC square less than BC square, or this condition or this condition. If one of the condition is holds good, then we conclude given triangle is obtuse angle triangle. What is acute angle triangle condition? Sum of squares of any two sides is greater than square of third side. Then tell me what is condition for right angle triangle. Already you know condition of right angle triangle. Right angle triangle is sum of squares of two sides equal to square of third side. Means given triangle, suppose it is A, B, C. AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. Sum of squares of any two sides equal to square of third side, then clearly that triangle is right angle triangle. Sum of squares of two sides is greater than square of third side, then it is acute. If any one of these three conditions is holds good, then we conclude obtuse angle triangle, right? Next, types of quadrilaterals. Types of quadrilaterals. Suppose quadrilateral formed by A of x1, y1, B of x2, y2, C of x3, y3 and D of x4, y4. What is condition for a parallelogram? Given quadrilateral is said to be parallelogram. Midpoint of AC is equal to midpoint of BD. Here AC and BD are diagonals of the parallelogram. And AB square is not equal to BC square. AB square plus BC square is not equal to AC square, right? Or else I will write the condition. Here something went wrong during typing. Here not equal to sign, here also not equal to sign. Suppose given quadrilateral is said to be a parallelogram. I will write parallelogram condition. Suppose A, B, C, D. This quadrilateral is said to be parallelogram. First condition, check whether adjacent sides are equal or unequal. If AB is not equal to BC, means two adjacent sides are unequal, means what you conclude about quadrilateral? Adjacents unequal means it is parallelogram or rectangle. What is difference between rectangle and parallelogram? In parallelogram also adjacent sides are unequal. Given quadrilateral is said to be parallelogram if AB is not equal to BC. two adjacent sides are unequal and diagonals are also unequal. What are the diagonals? AC is not equal to BD. And third condition, midpoint of AC is same as midpoint of BC. Just check whether adjacent sides are equal or unequal. Adjacent sides unequal and diagonals are also unequal means clearly that quadrilateral is a parallelogram. Midpoint of AC is equal to midpoint of BD. Here AC and BD are diagonals. Remember, suppose given quadrilateral is parallelogram, two adjacent sides are unequal. AB length is not equal to BC length, it is one condition, and diagonals are unequal, then clearly that quadrilateral is a parallelogram. Then what is condition for rectangle? Given quadrilateral is said to be rectangle. ABCD is said to be CD. ABCD one quadrilateral is said to be a rectangle. What is condition? In this case also adjacent sides are unequal. Rectangle. Rectangle. AB is not equal to BC. One condition. In rectangle, whether diagonals are equal or unequal? Diagonals equal. Means AC equal to BD. Remember, what is difference between parallelogram and rectangle? In parallelogram, adjacent sides are unequal, diagonals are also unequal. But in rectangle, adjacent sides are unequal, but diagonals are equal. Diagonals are equal. Adjacent sides unequal, diagonals equal means clearly that quadrilateral is a rectangle. And in this case also midpoint of diagonal AC is same as midpoint of diagonal BD, right? Next, square. Next quadrilateral, a square. What is condition for a square? Given quadrilateral is said to be a square, A, B, C and D. In square, adjacent sides are equal. First condition, AB is equal to BC. Sorry, AC is equal to BC. AB is equal to BC. And what about diagonals? Here, diagonals are also equal. AC diagonal is equal to BD diagonal. Adjacent sides equal. And diagonals are also equal. Then that quadrilateral is a square. Then next, rhombus. What is condition of given quadrilateral is said to be a rhombus? In rhombus, adjacent sides are equal, but diagonals are unequal. A, B, C and D. Here adjacent sides are equal. AB is equal to BC, but diagonals are unequal. AC is not equal to BD. Rectangle condition, adjacent sides unequal, diagonals equal, then quadrilateral is a rectangle. Adjacent sides are equal, diagonals are also equal, then that quadrilateral is a square. Adjacent sides equal, diagonals unequal, then that quadrilateral is a rhombus. Adjacent sides are unequal, diagonals are also unequal, then that quadrilateral is a parallelogram, right? Next point, if G of x0, y0 is centroid of, this is not D, triangle. triangle ABC whose two vertices are x1 comma y1 and x2 comma y2, then third vertex is, then third vertex x3 comma y3 is. In this case, two vertices and its centroid is given, then what is third vertex? Already you have formula g of x comma y is equal to, suppose g of x comma y is equal to formula x1 plus x2 plus x3 divided by 3 comma y1 plus y2 plus y3 divided by 3. This is centroid formula. But in this case they have given centroid is x0 comma y0 instead of x and y. Then in this case instead of xy, x0 and y0 they have given. Then just equating corresponding elements, then what you get? X0 is equal to x1 plus x2 plus x3 divided by 3 and y0 is equal to y1 plus y2 plus y3 divided by 3. Just simplify. In this case x3 y3 our requirement, means just cross multiplication 3 times x0 and take these two terms minus x1 minus x2, that's equal to x3, right? Then what is y3? Just cross multiplication 3 times y0 minus y1 minus y2, that's equal to y3. Means x3 comma y3 is 3 times x0 minus x1 minus x2 comma 3 times y0 minus y1 minus y2. Just by using centroid formula we can find third vertex. It is x coordinate of third vertex and y coordinate of third vertex, x coordinate of second vertex, y coordinate of second vertex, x coordinate of first vertex, y coordinate of first vertex. Just by using centroid formula, just rewrite this, then you get third vertex. No need to remember this formula. Remembering all the formula is impossible. Just remember this formula, centroid formula and rearrangement, right? Just remember this formula, from this we can find this one, right? Third vertex is equal to, by using centroid formula. Then missing vertex of the triangle, missing vertex, if D, E, F are midpoints of the sides AB, BC, CA of triangle ABC, then suppose midpoints are given, then how to find their vertices, right? Instead of giving vertex A, vertex B and vertex C, suppose midpoints are given. D is midpoint of AB, D, D is midpoint of AB, then E is midpoint of, E is midpoint of BC and it is F midpoint of AC, then A is equal to, whenever midpoints coordinates are given, D, E and F are given, then how to find vertices? A is equal to D plus F minus A. And remember one thing, if you want A, then just A is equal to, add which one is opposite, that is minus E, and add remaining two, D plus F. If you want B, just it is trick to remember this formula, right? If you want B, minus F only, add remaining two, D plus E minus F. If you want vertex C, which one is opposite to C? D, means minus D, add remaining two, E plus, E plus F minus D. This is just to remember. If you want vertex A, then minus E. If you want vertex B, then minus F, remaining two positive. Remaining two, add remaining two vertices. If you want C, means minus D, add these two. If you want B, minus F, add these two. This is, whenever midpoints are given, then we can find vertices of the triangle using midpoints. This is formula. When D, E, F are the midpoints of sides of the triangle, then vertex A is equal to D plus F minus E. Then B is equal to D plus E minus F. C, vertex C equal to E plus F minus D. Right? And this formula is not necessary. And not necessary. Then, length of the median of the triangle, right? Length of the median of the triangle. Whenever side lengths are given, A, B, and C, side BC length is taken as small a, and side length AC is taken as small b, and side length AB is taken as small c. Small ABC are side lengths of triangle ABC. Then it is one of the median through vertex A, and B is median through vertex B, and CF is median through vertex C. Suppose when side lengths are known, then directly we can find lengths of medians. Whenever side lengths are known, then median, length of the median is equal to, AD median is equal to 1 by 2 times square root of 2 times, through vertex A means just right, B square plus C square minus A square. For remember this formula, one trick. Through vertex A means minus A square is there. B vertex, through vertex B means 1 by 2 times square root of. Through vertex B means minus B square, 2 times remaining 2 sides. Except B, A square plus C square. Through vertex C means CF. Length of the median CF is equal to 1 by 2 times square root of. Throw C means minus C square, add remaining 2. Twice the remaining. A square plus B square. Length of the median through vertex A is 1 by 2 times. Through vertex A is there, so minus A square. Or else you can write 2B square plus 2C square minus A square. This is nothing but 2 times B square plus C square minus A square. 2 times A square plus C square minus B square. 1 by 2 times square root of 2 times A square B square minus C square. Length of the medians through vertex A, vertex B, vertex C. Here already given AB length C units. Length of the sides of the triangle is small ABC. Small ABC are side lengths, and capital ABC are angles of the triangle, right? Length of the median. Length of the median through vertex A is 1 by 2 times square root of 2 times B square plus C square minus A square. Length of the median through vertex B is 1 by 2 times square root of 2 times A square plus C square minus B square. Length of the median through vertex C is 1 by 2 times square root of 2 times A square plus B square minus C square. This is about synopsis of 2D geometry. Whenever it necessary, I will explain once again, right? While solving problem, I will explain few more synopsis point, right? In the level 1, first question, if the distance between 3 comma 4 and a comma 2 is 2 root 2, then what is a value? First problem, distance between 3 comma 4 and a comma 2 is 2 root 2, then a is, what they have given, take this point as a, first point is a and second point is b. Distance between AB they have given. AB distance equal to, how much they have given? 2 root 2. Distance between AB they have given. AB is equal to 2 root 2. Then distance between AB, square root of, While finding distance between A and B, A coordinates x1, y1, B coordinates x2, y2. x2 minus x1 whole square. x2 means A. A minus 3 whole square. x1 minus x2 whole square or x2 minus x1 whole square. Plus y2 minus y1 whole square. That is 2 minus 4 whole square is equal to 2 root 2. Right? Then square root of A minus 3 whole square plus 4, right? 2 minus 4. 2 minus 4 whole square is minus 2 whole square, that's equal to 2 root 2. Just squaring on both sides, then A minus 3 whole square plus 4 is equal to 8. Squaring on both sides, 2 square is 4, root 2 square is 2, 4 into 2 is 8. Then A minus B, sorry, not A minus B, then A minus 3 whole square is equal to, what you get? 4. Then A minus 3 is equal to plus or minus 2. If you take square root, plus or minus 2. Then A is equal to plus or minus 2, plus 3, sorry, minus 3, send it to RHS, then it will be A is equal to plus or minus 2, plus 3. Then what are the possible values? Then A is equal to 5 or A is equal to 1, right? First option. Clearly they have given distance between 3, 4 and a, 2 is 2 root 2, then A value is. What are the possible values? When A is equal to 5 or A is equal to 1, distance between these two points is clearly 2 root 2. Okay, thank you.